me Vicky T. Off the leash, I feel like a dog. I can't have the free. Keep it pee. Never needed you, but you needed me. Hello, Taurus. Check in with your girl for the last monthly reading of the year. Is that not crazy to say? I really don't understand anything anymore. I just feel like time has flown by. Let's discuss. We are here to talk about your life for the month of December. Check your chart. You could have any placement of Taurus, and some messages in here will definitely resonate. Open for bookings. My pricing and contact information is in the description box down below. All the info will be in the pinned comment in the comment section. I'm not sure how you're doing with this Mercury retrograde. If you want to tap me in, girl, and see what you could be dealing with, make sure you check out my Mercury retrograde readings. So we have pulled the signs for who could be around you during this time, what placements you guys might have, what other monthly readings might have some messages for you. We have Cancer, Leo, Capricorn, and then we have Scorpio showing on the bottom of the day. The first thing that comes to mind for me is Taurus. I feel like you could be done with a Scorpio, like you no longer talk to them. You have blocked them on everything. But I feel like the Scorpio still, like, wants to interact with you. They still want to talk to you. They still want to be involved with you in some sort of way. I don't know, girl. You know how Scorpios are. I feel like people with strong Scorpio energy to them, it's like they let go whenever they decide to let go, whether it's quietly or loudly. That's just my opinion. Strong water sign energy is here, so you could have strong water in your chart. There could be a water sign around you in some sort of way, or some messages in this reading will definitely pertain to a water sign. Overall energy for the month of December looks kind of crazy. I can't remember who, somebody else had this overall energy. It's either Gemini or Leo. I can't remember. Hussy, Hefe, and Jezebel with return to sender showing up on the bottom of the deck. So, you know, whether you are a woman or a man, if some feminine energy has already shown you that they can be dirty, they can be trifling, they cannot be trusted, please don't allow this person to come back around you. In some cases, I could be talking about a Taurus. I could be talking about a Taurus woman. But Taurus, like I said, whether you are a man or a woman, I'm warning you about a specific feminine energy. Or I'm warning you about somebody who is going to try to come around you who has a very problematic woman attached to them. Now, this just isn't in regards to like an ex or a romantic situation. This could be, you know, you got a friend who got a sister who don't know how to keep her hands to herself, who don't know how to shut up, who don't know how to act. It could be a situation like that. Like someone who just keeps a problematic feminine energy around them. That I feel like, shit, they guilty by association. I don't want nothing to do with you if that's the type of person that you want to associate with. Let's pull some cards. Excuse me. What's happening to the Taurus zodiac in the month of, oh my God, in the month of December 2024? Ooh. I love seeing this card. I really do. We have the Temperance with the Chariot. So, Taurus, I see a lot of you guys have been taking very good care of yourself, whether it's in regards to you staying active, staying in shape, staying healthy, very good, feeling very much vegan. Some of you guys could live a very vegan lifestyle, have a vegan lifestyle, vegetarian. You don't really eat a lot of meat. Pescatarian, okay? That's my other shit. You take care of yourself, and I think it shows, all right? Chariot, and you know, I just feel like you're someone who was kind of like in their own lane during this time. And with the Temperance card, it's very much apparent that you're someone who has been, you know, who pours into your cup, okay? Yeah, look. Chariot and the Star, you know, I'm on the grind all the time, okay? Georgia, I don't know. Somebody here could be from Georgia, live in Georgia. Yeah, look at this. Hierophant, it's your granddaddy. But this is a Taurus card, but this is someone who is being divinely led and guided, especially with the Chariot and the Star card. Like, a lot of you guys have a strong ancestral team, a strong spiritual gifts. You know, you ever just had that feeling to where, I don't know, things just always work out for me? A lot of you guys have those experiences. And it's not just one, two, three times. It's like, girl, it happens so frequently. I couldn't tell you. Girl, I could tell you about what this happened this morning. Okay? What's happened to the Taurus zodiac in the month of December of 2024? You know, with me speaking so highly of you, so highly of your situation, it ain't got nothing to do with labels, luxury, money, bills, nothing like that. I feel as though, with, like I said, me speaking of how, speaking highly of you, you gotta be careful. Because it's probably a bitch outside of you with the evil eye. There's somebody outside of you who don't like that, who don't like that you living so well. Ten of Pentacles and the Two of Cups. You in a cool little relationship. You know, you're dating someone. You're in a relationship. You're in a marriage. You're with somebody that you really love, you really care about. Or you're single. Temperance and the Ten of Pentacles. And you're somebody who's career-driven, pursuing your goals. Nice. I like it. Wow. Wow. It's really nasty outside you, girl. Lock the doors. Shut your windows and close your doors, all right? We have the Two of Cups, Ten of Swords, Three of Swords, and the Devil. Taurus, I'm seeing a lot of you guys are doing better spiritually, mentally, physically, ever since you decide to separate yourself from family, a work situation, or romantic connection. Two of Cups. It's like things are looking so up for you. It's kind of crazy. Things look so up for you. You know, it's given, like, it's very apparent who's the problem between you and certain people, because whenever you separate from them, you almost, you glow. You go through a certain glow up, and people who you separate from, they might go through a certain, you know, or just becomes, like I said, it becomes very apparent who's the problem between you and, like I said, the people who you are deciding to separate yourself from. What's happening to the Taurus zodiac in the month of December of 2024? Whoa, you saw that? Four of Wands, Hermit. Tis the season. I definitely see, Taurus, you are, for this month, you could be wanting or needing to spend time with family. Temperance, Ten of Pentacles, and the Four of Wands, or just those that you're closest to. Like I said, I feel like tis the season. You know, the festive times tend to bring those sorts of emotions and feelings out. But I see the Hermit card here. A lot of you guys might have been isolating yourself as of recently, kind of sticking to yourself. And I feel like being around those that you care about, getting out there and doing things that you like doing, having certain experiences for yourself could definitely help with your feelings of isolation, okay? It's like I'm hearing sometimes it's cool. It's okay for you to step out with friends, step out with family, step out by yourself and have a night out on the town. You know, paint it beige. You know, you ain't got to go crazy. It's just make sure you come out of your solitude from time to time, okay? Check in with your girl. Check in with your man. Let us know you're still breathing, okay? Temperance, practice that balance of, like I said, spending time with yourself, being in solitude, but also putting time, effort, and energy into towards things outside of that solitude. What's happening to the Taurus zodiac in the month of December 2024? Ah! Queen of Swords, Ten of Swords. Ooh, yikes. I think it could be time for you guys to quit some sort of like part-time job. Ten of Swords, Emperor, Two of Pentacles, and the Magician. It's like if there's something here that's not paying you enough to pay your bills, I just heard on time, it's not suitable. Now, we're not in the day and age anymore to where you can just up and quit a job and find something else. You probably gotta, you know, wait until you find something better suited for you, but I do feel as though some of you guys, it could be time for you to start looking for something else if a current source of income isn't even, like I said, paying the bills for you on time. if you leave the door open for somebody from your past, High Priestess and the Six of Cups, it's gonna always be an on and off situation, or one foot in, one foot out the door. I feel as though someone's open to always having access to you if you're open to always having access to them. And I don't know what kind of relationship that is. It's not Two of Pentacles. It's a transaction. Y'all might as well be on paper together, have a fucking contract, because that's not no relationship. And I feel as though that is how whoever that individual moves, that's how they like it. Emperor. They can do and move however they want to, as long as, like I said, you still allow them to have access to you. Ten of Swords. No matter how many times y'all have started, stopped. Okay. This is the case. This could be the case between you and a fire sign, air sign, or an earth sign, specifically Gemini, Aries, Capricorn, Virgo, Scorpio. What's happening to the Taurus zodiac in the month of December 2024? Knight of Wands, the Hermit. Yeah, I see, Taurus, there's a certain there's a certain stability that I feel like you have that you need to be careful about being compromised by other people or by external circumstances. If it's in regards to external circumstances, this could be in regards to your career or your living situation. Some of you guys, remember how I brought up earlier a job not paying you enough to pay your bills on time? Some of you guys might go through some sort of like income fluctuation to where your costs and expenses go up, or a job isn't paying you as much as they used to pay you. Your hours get cut or layoffs happen. I'm hearing some of you guys need to be prepared for things like that. And with the Knight of Wands and the Queen of Swords, you need to be able to be in a position to where you can easily adapt. But you're not all in, you know, if that makes sense. Like you're not going up and down with things around you, if that makes sense. With the Knight of Wands and the Four of Wands, I'm just saying it's important for you to have a certain foundation about yourself to where whenever the world starts to do its twists and turns, you can still, you know, stand still. You're not being thrown around as well. So it's important to always have a source of income. It's important to, you know, create a means of housing for yourself, whether it be, you know, your own or, you know, family. Knight of Wands for me is don't just be out here naked. Oh, that felt so good. Y'all hurt my knee. What's happening to the Taurus zodiac in the month of December of 2024? And you need to be careful about letting other people kind of impede on that, you know. Just because you ain't stable don't mean that you automatically entitled to my stability. And this could be jobs, you know, expecting you to, you know, work triple to make up for their short-staffedness. This could be, you know, friends expecting you to pick up the tab, pick up the bill because they can't keep a job, you know, like. You shouldn't be expected to always pick up the pieces, Taurus, and be careful about being put in situations like that, putting yourself in situations like that. We have the Strength, Three of Swords, Ten of Wands. Mm. also seeing some of you guys might be faced with situations to where you had to separate yourself from people because they're getting themselves too deep into things. Like, I'm here, you can only be there for someone so much before their downfall start to spill over onto you. Like I said, this could come from people or you being attached to certain communities, companies, environments, to where, like I said, the downfalls of those situations start to spill over into your place of peace, your space. What's happening? Oh. Hi, girls, Divine Feminine, Empress. Oh, I could be talking to the girls or I could be talking about just someone. Listen, Taurus, stay away from this Leo, this Scorpio, this Aquarius, this Pisces, this Libra. It could be anybody. You need to stay away from someone who, with the Seven of Swords and the Knight of Cups, if you ever had somebody lie to you in your face, it completely changes the way you view this person, depending on the lie, the severity of the lie. Whenever you've seen someone steal from you, whenever you've seen someone betray you, whenever you've witnessed someone throw you, whenever you've actually experienced firsthand betrayal from somebody, I feel as though with the Five of Wands, there will always be some sort of hurdles or obstacles dealing with this person from then on, because now there's something that you have to acknowledge. This person is capable of throwing you under the bus. This person is capable of hurting you. So who's to say it won't happen again? Oh, because they said it wouldn't. That's what they said, huh? Remember that. What's happening to the Taurus Zodiac in the month of December of 2024? Can't open your home up to everybody. Look what just came out. It's tragic. Seven of Swords. So when I went to go show y'all this card, the King of Swords fell out, but it fell out like this. Yeah, there's someone here who wants to mask them, who doesn't want to come off as treacherous, but they are. I don't feel like this person is truthful. I feel like this person leads with lies. The Seven of Swords showed its face before the King of Swords did. This person leads with lies. And I just don't feel like you can trust somebody like that. This person leads with manipulation. Like I said, I don't feel like that's somebody that you can truly trust. So with the Seven of Swords, whenever they come, I just heard slithering your way, wanting to get back in your good graces, or you witnessed them do some shit to where it's like, hey, you next. Or it's only a matter of time before this spill onto your place of peace. Act accordingly. You remember how I told you this return to center card is on the bottom of the deck? You know, you did this, Taurus. You did this with somebody, girl. Ugh, you're so smart. Taurus, you cut somebody off. Like, I feel as though you sent somebody back from whence they came, back under the bridge you go. I don't know. This person could now be a scammer. I don't know. I don't want to. That's what the fuck I said. I just don't think this person lives comfortably. I don't think this person lives morally. It's like they've actually worsened ever since you decided to stop dealing with them. This could be the reason why you stopped dealing with them. They got worse. You know, you're just like, oh girl, I can't get down with that. What's happening to the Taurus Zodiac in the month of December of 2024? The Justice. Four of Pentacles. Yeah, again, please be careful about not having a foundation for yourself, because you never know when an unexpected situation or circumstance can happen and, you know, knock you on your ass. So it's important for you to always, you know, have money stored somewhere, have a backup plan, you know, knowing the importance of not putting all your eggs in one basket. Again, if you already see the toxicity or the harm that could come with you doing something, being involved with someone or being in a certain situation, don't do it. Please don't do it. Don't do it. Because with the Justice card, you can't be mad at what happens. You can't be mad at what could happen. Last card, what's happened to the Taurus zodiac in the month of December of 2024? Four of Swords with the Fool card. Now, what's kind of interesting is that no card in this reading belongs to you, Taurus. Maybe the Ten of Pentacles, but that's a Virgo card. So I really feel like I'm warning you about things outside of you, people outside of you. A lot of y'all's people. Not all money is good money. Somebody might come towards you with a certain job offer or opportunity. I don't think you should take it. It's like if this person, you know, wants you to act now, you know, sign on the dotted line right now, that, you know, time is of the essence. They're trying to, you know, rush you into doing something. Please put the bat signal out there, okay? Alert the town. Alert the villagers. This goes in regards to relationships. Whenever someone is trying to rush a relationship with you, alert the villagers. All right? This person needs somewhere to stay. That's what that sounds like. Just know, return to sender. No situations that you should stay away from, okay? Please. Sag, Virgo, Aries, Libra, Leo, and Aquarius. What went on in this reading might apply to these signs. All right, make sure you have.